What should I do if I'm having symptoms of COVID-19 and want to see my physician to be checked? And what happens if I need treatment? Most symptoms of COVID-19 are going to be pretty mild. So you can treat it like a cold and stay home and nurse yourself back to health as you would with any type of an illness. If you feel your symptoms are worse than that or you need advice, most physicians and all of our physicians at Weill Cornell are performing video visits. This is probably the best way to first interact with your physician, to contact them, to get set up for a video visit, and to go through your symptoms. At that time, your physician will tell you whether you need to come in for further evaluation or to give you some advice on how to manage yourself at home. As you probably know, there's no specific treatment for COVID-19 at this time, but we would give you advice on how to manage your symptoms and what things to look for in case your symptoms are getting worse. What should I do if I have a health concern unrelated to COVID-19 and feel I need to see a physician? So if you have symptoms of any sort and feel you need to see a physician, at this time, the easiest thing and safest thing to do is to set up a video visit. At that time, your physician will evaluate you. And if it's determined that you really need to be seen in person, then your physician can set up a time for you to come into the office and be evaluated in a safe way and take care of whatever issues you have that are going on at that time. How do I know whether the condition I have can be taken care of with video visit or if I need to go to my doctor's office? Some of these things may be pretty obvious. So if you feel you need to be examined, you think you might have broken a bone or you're having abdominal pain that's most significant when you're examined, or you feel like you need lab work or other tests, then obviously those kind of visits may not be amenable to a video visit. But many things can be evaluated by video visit, and the physician can often teach you how to examine yourself, how to press on your belly, what areas to press on, etc. But beyond that, or if it's pretty clear to you that you're going to need some additional testing like chest x-rays or lab work or other tests, as I mentioned, then it's probably best to just set up an in-person visit to start. What can I do if I'm unable to use telemedicine because of lack of internet access, the right computer hardware or software, or technical skills? If you don't have the technology available or you don't think you know how to perform a video visit, often staff in an office can help you set up what you need to perform these visits. But if you're still not able to get that to work, or if you truly don't have the technology at home, the old-fashioned way of getting care by calling your physician's office and asking for advice and either speaking with a physician or waiting for a phone call back is a perfectly acceptable way to still get care during this time. Sometimes the phone call may lead to the feeling that you need to come into the office, and that is still also a very acceptable way to get care nowadays. What should I do if I have a previously scheduled routine medical checkup? If you have a previously scheduled routine visit that you don't consider urgent, it's probably best to defer it until a safer time when the stay-at-home recommendations are no longer in effect. Obviously, if you've got an urgent medical problem or if you've got a chronic medical problem that really requires some testing or evaluation, it is perfectly fine to call the office, set up a video visit, or set up an in-person visit. But if you don't feel that's necessary, it's probably better to wait a little while until we're sure that it's safe for people to take the subways, travel, and really be seen in a physician's office. What if I have regular appointments with my doctor that are more complicated? If you have chronic medical problems and your physician has recommended that you be seen, they'll make sure that you get seen in a safe way. So if you've been reached out to, or if you've reached out to your physician and the recommendation is that you come in to get blood work or to get an exam, it is perfectly fine to do that. What if I have a situation that can't be handled by video visit, but I am concerned about going into a healthcare facility for treatment because of the risk of COVID? We've got a lot of ways now that we're managing patients and managing our offices by masking patients, by cleaning offices, by making sure we're separating sick and healthy patients. So if a video visit is not appropriate and an office visit is needed, you can be sure that we'll make sure that it's safe for you to come in. I've seen that some testing labs and urgent care clinics are offering COVID-19 antibody tests. How are these different from COVID diagnostic tests, and how do I know whether I should get one? So it's important to understand the difference between COVID antibody tests and COVID diagnostic tests. The COVID diagnostic test is the test where we put a swab up into your nose to look for actual virus. That's called a nasopharyngeal swab, and that helps us diagnose active coronavirus infection. The other test is the antibody test that you may have heard a lot about. And that test looks for antibodies in your blood that helps show whether you have been previously infected with coronavirus. The problem with the antibody test right now is that there's a lot of variability in how sensitive and specific these tests are, meaning there's cross-reactivity. So a positive test may not show that you've been infected with COVID-19, but that you've been infected with one of the older coronaviruses. So that doesn't really help us at all. The other thing is we don't really know whether the antibody confers immunity. So if you have an antibody to something like chickenpox or other viral illnesses, we know that that antibody protects you against getting chickenpox again. But we do not know that about this coronavirus antibody test. So at this time, even if you had a positive antibody, we're not able to tell you that you're safe or that you can change your behavior or stop doing social distancing or any other behaviors that we're currently recommending for people. So at this time, other than research reasons, we are not recommending that people generally get this antibody test because it does not help us figure out whether you've had disease or whether you can change any of your behaviors. The hope is that in the future, when we learn more about it, we will be able to tell you that, and then we will be recommending that people get good, reliable antibody testing.